Harry, it's absolutely fantastic to have you here tonight. What excited you about this play? What made you want to come and see it?
Well, I heard lots about it when I was at the Royal Court. And of course, when I went to Jamie, I knew that this was a very big show for him back upstairs, I think. So I was really excited about seeing it. And the cast that are involved are great. And it's lovely to be back as well. So yeah, just can't wait to see it.
Of course, you worked with Jamie, the director, before. What defines him as a director? What's he like to work with?
I think the show we did was... His direction so precise and felt and realised, and his taste is impeccable. I mean, whenever you go see a show that Jamie's got his stamp on, you know you're in for a very clever, heartfelt, kind of precise show with performances that are very bold and driven. And I guess, you know, with this subject matter and this play, it sounds like hopefully it'll be the same, really.
What are you working on at the moment? What's coming up next for you?
I've got a bit of a break, which is nice. I'm doing a bit of writing, which is cool. And then I'm doing King Lear. I'm not playing King Lear, obviously. But I'm playing the fool in King Lear in Chichester, which will be good fun. So I'm looking forward to that.
Of course, I mean, fans are used to seeing you on the big screen, of course, in the Potter franchise. But what is it about working in theatre on stage that excites you as a performer?
I think... Because I went to drama school, and that was what drama school was about, really. It's about, you know, getting ready to do theatre. And I think it just seemed like a natural progression for me to go and do that side. I mean, the thrill of theatre is amazing. I mean, there's a different thrill on sets, but the thrill of being on stage in front of people and telling a story, nothing can really beat it. It's a really amazing experience.
I think the last time we spoke to you was actually at the launch of the Warner Brothers Harry Potter Studio Tour. And yeah, I mean, have you had a chance to look around it since then? What did you think?
No, I haven't. I looked around on that day, but apart from that, I haven't been back. But it seems to be doing quite well, I think. And so, yeah.
I mean, obviously for fans, I mean, they miss the franchise. But for you, I mean, what's it like now that's all over? I mean, do you still go back and watch the films? Do you still stay in touch with your friends from the cast?
Not really. I mean, I haven't seen the films for quite a while, actually. And you know, you bump into people every now and again, but everyone seems to be doing their thing, you know. Dan's just up the road, and you know, so you bump into people now and again, which is always nice.
I mean, obviously you must get asked this a lot, but looking back, is there one memory in particular that you hold as your most special, your favourite memory?
Probably the first film, everything about the first film and it being the first outing, and just what that was, really, you know. People not knowing what we were doing, and being very young and in this kind of world of, you know, this huge set and stuff. That was kind of amazing.
Of course, I mean, it's a wonderful world of characters, but what do you think your character specifically brought to it?
I don't know, really. Just to be not very nice and to be a bit, yeah, just to be a bit disgusting and horrible, really. So yeah, I think that.
That you're so lovely in real life, and thanks for talking to us. Enjoy the play. We maybe see you at the after party.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. Cheers, Harry.